Hopefully everyone's having a great morning, afternoon, or evening, depending on where you're watching this in the world. My name is EQ, and welcome to the Stonkaholic Space Station. Now, in this episode, we're going to be talking about Hathor, or HTR. This is a next-level project, especially considering their white paper and thesis behind the project. But before we get into all that, if you could take a second to throw a like on this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, go check out our Crypto Accelerator program or our Discord group. And without further ado, let's get this intro rolling. So Hathor is currently ranked 237th on CoinMarketCap. We're sitting at $1.98 with a market cap of 441 million. So there is still some good room for growth on this project. You can get a 4x move on this and still be under 2 billion market cap, which is great to see. All right, off the bat, you can notice that they already have capital portfolio. So there's VC money in this project. And they have quite a few listings on KuCoin, CoinX, Gate.io, and so on and so forth. So with Hathor, you're able to create a token in less than 1 minute. It's a scalable and easy to use blockchain for digital assets. There's high scalability, it's easy to use, there's no gas fees. There's a built-in atomic swap, so different tokens can be reliably exchanged in the same transaction. And they have nano contracts, which are easier and safer implementations of smart contracts. So obviously they're on the next level. So the technology solves the problem of scalability with a novel architecture using both DAG and blockchain intertwined. And you can go through their executive summary, their white paper, which we'll touch on a little bit later. They have token atomic swaps, custom tokens, nano contracts, if you want to go through all of this. So feel free to go through any of these documents and read through them like nano contracts, and you'll be able to learn exactly why these nano contracts are great and what they do and what they bring, how they contact and communicate with Oracle, so on and so forth. Now their roadmap, instead of telling you what they're going to be doing, they give you the key features that are going to be available in the future on their platform. So they're going to extend their ERC token compatibilities. They're going to have a DEX of tokens with the built-in atomic swaps. They can build a true decentralized exchange for all tokens. They'll be improving their nano contracts. The Oracle integration will be implemented so they can have external outputs on their nano contracts. So you have side DAGs and side chains, and you'll even have the possibility of having a private DAG that is secured by the main DAG. So DAG is going to stand for directed acrylic graph, and it's just a really fancy way of talking about how nodes and oracles would be contacting and communicating with each other. And I'm not going to go too far in depth with this white paper, but I would definitely take a little bit of time and do your own diligence and research. They go through the entire process of how the DAG works, all the algorithms, all of the calculations and theorems that they're running. Everything is available, it's transparent, it's open source, it's great to see. Now the guy that made this is an OG. The crazy part about this is that he even has a thesis about this that he has written already. You know, this guy's from Brazil, so this is why it's in Portuguese, but he's already written a final thesis. He's a doctorate, and he definitely knows this very well if he's able to go to Stanford and talk to their graduate school of business students and talk to them about how AI is the new electricity. So this guy's next level, and that's why I'm very bullish on this project as a whole. So in short, Hathor is a transactional consensus platform. They propose solutions to the problems of scalability and decentralization maintenance among distributed ledger networks by including a chain of mined blocks inside of a DAG of transactions. The blockchain ensures security when the number of transactions per second is small, whereas the DAG prevails when the number increases significantly. The primary result is that it seems to work correctly under any number of transactions per second. Now, one of the primary problems for creating digital money is how to prevent double spending. As the money is digital and copies can be made, what can prevent counterfeiting? What would prevent users from sending copies of the same money or two to more people? And that's precisely what the blockchain solves. And the current solution behind fiat money is having a single issuer or a central bank, then trusting the financial institutions and regulators. Now, the concept of transferring money using cryptography was really presented in 1983, which people don't really realize that it's been around for quite some time. And they go on to go about Bitcoin a little bit more. They talk about IOTA and how IOTA uses DAGs. IOTA is a big project on Coinbase, so they're verifying the DAG use. You have Constellation DAG, you have all these other DAG projects that are starting to pick up a lot of steam. Now, within their architecture, they're gonna start talking about these directed acrylic graphs, how they work, how they function, how they read these nodes, and how these nodes and oracles will communicate with each other. So this is a very technical project, and if you're looking for something that has a lot of use case and can last for a long time longevity-wise, this has a fantastic use case. And this is pretty much as in-depth of a white paper as you can ask for. Looking at these technicals, we're looking pretty overbought at the moment. Now, the RSI does have a little bit more room. We might see a little bit more of a pump. We could see this potentially come, let's say, up here and test this double top, and then officially end this run on being overbought. But at the same time, let's just play this out hypothetically and say that this was the top right here and that we could pull it down a little bit. These would be my ideal buying opportunities and areas that you could take advantage of DCA. Obviously, that's not financial advice. None of this is financial advice. Trade at your own risk and use your own diligence when trading. But for myself personally, I am looking at these values as pretty good areas to buy in and potential DCA opportunities. Now, if this does want to come down and fulfill, and let's say stop at the 50 continuation, I'll be aiming near the TP1 or TP2 right around in the general area. But all in all, long term, we're still looking strong. This is a daily chart, and as you can see, we've got a green signal on the VFI, which is a great thing to see. This was a strong buy signal. If you would have used a Nada Yar as well, you would have gotten a strong buy confirmation. And all in all, this project does have a lot of room for growth. You're talking about a project with a $400 million market cap. So with that in mind, if you think that it has a lot of potential, you could 10x, and that's going to put you at a $4 billion market cap, which will probably put you in the top 40 to 30 projects, relatively speaking. So when we're talking about the future, for example, why I say relative is because once the market cap goes up, so right now it might take you only $2 billion to get into the top 50, but in, you know, a couple months or whatever it might take you $4 billion to get into the top 50. So that's why we say it's a relative number. And that's going to about wrap up this video on Hathor. If you didn't get a chance to before, make sure to go throw a like on this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Hopefully you have a great morning, afternoon, or evening, depending on where you're watching this in the world. And we'll catch you in the next one.